You probably spend an awful lot of time right here in Gmail, but are you aware of all of the Gmail settings and how they can affect your email experience? Well, in today's video, I want to share with you 7 Gmail settings, clarify what they do, and see if you want to make some changes to your own account. So to get started off, we want to get into settings. We want to hover over the gearbox icon, and we also want to select settings, and that's going to bring us here to the general tab. All of the settings that we're looking at here are found within that general tab. Now, the first one I want to highlight is maximum page size. By default, Gmail usually has this set at 50 conversations, meaning 50 emails per page, but you can actually expand that to 100 if you like, but you can also go in the other direction. And I find for some of my clients, they actually like it if there's only maybe 20 or 25 because they have fewer emails staring back at them at any given time. This will also help your page to load faster depending on your internet connection, so make sure you take a look at your maximum page size. Now, the second one on our list is undo send, and I know a lot of Gmail users that are not familiar with this setting at all. Let me show you how it works. I'm going to go back over here, and I'm going to compose a new message, and let me just send it to a test email that I have here. I don't even need a subject line. I'm just going to say, you know, Scott, you are an idiot. I'm so mad with you right now. I'm going to hit send. And down below in the left-hand corner, you can see there's an undo. You know what? Let's undo that. You know what? I was a little hot and bothered. Scott isn't an idiot. I better not send that, right? Let me rethink what I want to send to him. But as you may have noticed in the previous screen, I have it set for 5 seconds. So if I do hit send again, we're going to see this happen again. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and that undo is going to be, it's gone. Now the email has been sent. Now I can't take it back, and I better be ready for what Scott replies to me with that particular email. If you'd like a little bit of extra time, what you can do with the undo send is you can increase this all the way out to 30 seconds, and it will just last that much longer in the lower left-hand side if you do want to retract that particular email. Now, the third one on my list today has to do with sending a reply to a message and automatically archiving it, and it's called send and archive. Now, by default, this is turned to hide the send and archive button, but I've turned it on to show you how it looks like and how it works. When you're replying to a message within Gmail, you know, in many cases, you probably want to go ahead and archive that message immediately afterwards. You don't want it to cloud out your inbox. It'll be sent to the all mail section here within Gmail. So you can always find it. You can always search for it. But here is that message that I just sent, this test message. And when I hit reply, you'll notice down below, my buttons look a little bit different. Instead of just having the blue send button, I've got a send plus reply, or send plus archive icon. I could also just hit this white one, which would be the traditional send. But what's going to happen is that this email is in my inbox right now, and you know, you said what did you say to me? I'm going to hit send and reply. So when I hit this, it's going to send the email as usual, but now it returns me to my inbox, and it is now in the archive folder. Again, I can search for it, I can go find it, but it's no longer here in my inbox. This isn't something that a lot of people use, but it can be really handy, really helpful, especially so you can go back to your inbox immediately after hitting the send. You're not remaining on that page, you're not remaining on that email, you can get on to the next message in your inbox. All right, the next one in our list, I'm sort of combining two here, and it has to do with Smart Compose. You can see that there's two labels here, Smart Compose Personalization, and then Smart Compose. I'm not exactly sure why they didn't group these together and maybe put them in a different order. I'm going to start with the bottom one first. So Smart Compose has to do with giving you writing suggestions. And you may have noticed this on the mobile version of your Gmail account. Maybe it's turned off. Maybe you have to go in here and turn it off. But what writing suggestions will do is that when you are writing a message, I'm going to open up this sample email here. I'm going to hit reply, and I'm going to say, yes, I can meet, I can do that. There, even after hitting the N in can, you can see I've got some gray text that says, do that. It's suggesting, is that what you meant to say? Is that the type of thing that you were going to say? If I want to accept it, all I have to do is hit the tab key on my keyboard, and now the cursor goes all the way to the end. I mean, it's helping me to write my email, but maybe I don't want to use that. So I can just keep typing. I don't have to look at it. I don't have to acknowledge it. I can meet on, and again, it's giving me another suggestion here. I can meet on Thursday. I can see that that was the question for this email. Again, I can hit tab. I can hit period. See you. Look at that. I haven't even finished the word you. See you then. So it's helping me to craft and write my email in a faster way. So that is Smart Compose. But now up above, we have Smart Compose Personalization, and you can either have this on or off. What this means, and it gives us a brief description down below, is that it will start to learn your own writing style. So it's going to take a look at the way that you've written other emails, the way you've replied to other emails, and are there certain phrases? Are there certain words? Are there certain ways that you write an email? And it will start to suggest those as a part of Smart Compose. So for example, do you start your emails with hi or hello or hey or however you start it out? Gmail is going to learn what you typically use, and then it's going to suggest it. So it's going to personalize it for your use. So Smart Compose Personalization and also Smart Compose. All right, moving on to the next one in our list has to do with nudges. And I think this is a really important one. This has to do with giving you suggestions to emails that you should maybe reply to or emails that you should be following up on. So we've got both of those suggestions here. The first one, suggest emails to reply to. So maybe these are emails that have a question in them, like the sample one that we just used there, when someone is asking me if I can meet this week. If I leave that for a couple of days and I don't reply to it, Gmail may bring that email back to my inbox and say, do you want to reply to this? Should you reply to this? And maybe you already had a phone conversation. Maybe you already spoke to this individual, but Gmail's trying to be helpful if you have this on, saying, hey, here's one or two emails that maybe you should take a second look at. Now, the one below suggests emails to follow up on. This has to do with emails that you have sent. So maybe you've sent a question to someone else and Gmail notices that that person has not replied. There's been no response to that question or that email. So after a couple of days, I'm not exactly sure the time frame or the algorithm associated with this, but Gmail's going to start to learn and pick up on things, and it might bring back a few emails to make that suggestion for you. So nudges, I think it can't hurt to just leave these on. I keep them on. I don't use them very often. I actually use some other tools such as Boomerang to help me with these types of emails. But it doesn't hurt to just leave these on, right? You don't want to leave anything behind or forget something in your inbox. All right, and the last one on our list today has to do with button labels. And this is the one found a little bit lower down on the screen. We've got either icons or we have text. Now, by default, what you're going to see for most users is that you're going to see the icons within your inbox. And what that means is that up here, you are usually going to see things like the archive icon, the spam icon, the delete, which is like a trash can. But I've already turned these to labels. So here you can see I've got the actual text-based labels. So you can actually make that change. If you're not familiar with the icons themselves, or maybe you just want to get more familiar for a short period of time, you can get the text-based labels instead of, here's a good example, right? This is what the archive icon looks like. Otherwise, that's what's going to appear up here at the top of your screen. Well, I would love to hear from you next. Are there some other settings here within Gmail that you think are really, really valuable and others should know about? Make sure to share them with all of us in the comments down below. Remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.